Hey guys, welcome back. So today we are going to be listening to the Jonas Brothers' newest release, the album. We will be skipping Wings and Waffle House because as singles, we've already heard them. Yeah. And we do have the lyrics.
Yes.
So if we're looking this way, it's because I really love to read lyrics to songs that I don't know because I listen to it better that way. I have ADHD, it's fine. So we're just gonna go ahead and get right into it. Experience.
I was not expecting that at all.
I loved it. It was groovy, dude.
I definitely got Bee Gees vibes. Like, that actually sounds like it could be like a Bee Gees song.
Yeah.
I think my mom is gonna like it.
I liked that one. The second verse I liked better than the first verse. I think just all over, it's just more cohesive. It makes more sense than the first verse.
When they said winter with the AC, I turned to you.
You literally said I would never have the AC on in the winter. So I was like, yeah, no, that's crazy. But other than the first verse, I was like, but then Joe hit that falsetto, so it was fine.
Yeah, I feel like that sort of distracted us.
Missed the first half of the first chorus because I was so blown away by that.
Well, we weren't expecting that
to start off the album.
I feel like whoever created this track list so far, first track, did a pretty good job. Joe's always had that falsetto.
Yeah, but he never does it.
But I've never heard anything like this.
Not like that. That was whew. So the next song is Montana Sky.
Oh, this sounds like Nick Jonas and the Administration already.
It was good. I wouldn't say it was great, but it was good.
You still like Miracle better?
I definitely like Miracle. So far is my favorite that I've heard, but I really like the story. In fact, I think I like the lyrics of this song better. Than I like the lyrics of Miracle.
Yes, I agree.
But I like the sound of Miracle better than
I feel like
song.
This song would also really be like a good road trip song. Like just kind of driving
around. I
could see
us putting the windows down and like doing this with our hands out the window. It would be a really good earbud song too.
I think it really like sets the mood of like a nice summer day or just driving along the coast, having like a good scene.
Yeah, I feel like this is less of a beach song and more of a driving song.
I agree.
Especially because like it says like Montana skies, Georgia sunsets. Again, it talks about all these different places.
Now we gotta go to Montana. We gotta go to Georgia, Teresa.
I've driven through Georgia. I don't believe I've ever been to Montana. Okay, so the next song on the album is Wings. I'm gonna need some time for it to grow on me, I think.
Yeah, on your first listen.
My first listen to, I was not like super blown away. But I'm always open to re-listening and, you know, adapting to things. So we'll skip that one. So the next song that we'll listen to is Sail Away.
Oh, wow. Okay. I'm glad they have the lyrics up. Very psychedelic. Mm. Okay.
I'm like here for it. No idea where we are on the page.
I have no idea. Imagine in live how this is gonna sound.
There's the chorus. I was not convinced during the first verse, but once that pre-chorus hit, I was like, okay, like, I'm actually kind of vibing with this, and I really liked that outro.
There's definitely a theme going on here.
It's definitely summer. I really like that chorus. I like the refrain a lot.
Yeah.
The next song on the album is Americana.
Going on.
liked the verses. I think this is the first song where I liked the verses better than the chorus.
Hmm.
Yeah.
There was a lot of layers to that song,
were a lot of layers to that song. It was cool. I think it was done nicely. I feel like this is definitely a song that you could put on in the background while you're cleaning.
Yeah.
I know that's, like, oddly specific, but I, like, have so many different playlists and so many different songs for so many different things. Like, that's just how I use music. So, this is, like, a cleaning
song. Your cleaning
song.
Playlist?
This is one of my cleaning songs.
Do you have a cleaning playlist?
I don't, but I should totally make one. I usually just listen.
Yeah, you gotta make
I
one.
I usually
now.
Either listen to Chaos Therapy or Road Trip or Sless and Teresa.
I think the Jonas Brothers have always had a lot of layers to their songs, though. Because before we did this reaction, I went back and just did, like, a general listen.
Mm-hmm.
And I noticed that there were a lot of layers and, like, different, like, kind of cool sound effects that they, like, pop in the background and
they
stuff.
They do to like kinda... to, they like to make it, keep it interesting.
Yeah, and I think the good thing about them is they don't take themselves too seriously, too.
Yeah. What I've liked about this album so far is that because they are doing, like, the 70s pop rock sound, it gives them a lot more room to kind of experiment with different things, which has been... It's been fun and exciting so far.
Yeah.
This seems like it's a good next album.
It's a good transition, I think, because Happiness Begins still...
It has some of these vibes, but it was tamer. And this, I feel like it's just taking it to the next level. That being said, we are only 5 songs in. We have 7... well, I guess 6 songs to go, so we'll skip Waffle House. But the next song is Celebrate.
I've heard a lot of good things about this.
Yeah, okay, I'm excited.
So...
Well, the fact that it has an exclamation point in the title makes me... feel very hopeful and excited about it, so let's get started.
Oh, more choir. Oh,
I'm here for it.
This is gonna be something that we're blasting. I could already picture it.
Oh, we're gonna look like morons. It's gonna be so much fun. So excited to, like,
that's like the cha-cha
slide.
I'm
so excited to, like, hip check to this song.
You're gonna make a dance for this. It's gonna be the new kind of going crazy.
Not a good dance, but yeah.
You said it had to be good.
Like, obviously, none of my dances are good. That's why I do it.
This is gonna be the new Gummy Gone Crazy.
You don't have to do something. You don't have to be good at something to do it. You can do it for fun. You know what the story kind of reminds me of?
What?
Roller Coaster. Way different sound.
Yeah.
But it's still the same, like, hey, we got through it.
Yeah.
And now, but now it's like, hey, we got through it. Let's get party. Let's go. I'm here for it, dude.
Roller Coaster was part one. This is part two.
I know.
This is like the sequel to Roller Coaster.
I know. This is like the, you know what? Screw it. Like, we're going to part. Like, don't get, Roller Coaster is one of my favorite songs from Happiness Begins. This is a road trip song.
But imagine this live, though.
Like, there better be confetti. The next song is Waffle House. We're going to skip it, but I grooved to Waffle House. I liked it.
I think I liked it
better than Wings.
You related to the story, too, of Waffle House.
I don't
remember. Having, like, a big family.
Oh,
and...
my gosh. Maybe I have 9 siblings, guys. It's a lot.
I have 0.
We've been discovering more and more recently that we're actually really similar.
We're both introverts.
For sure.
But we've known that, though. That's why we became friends, because we were both introverts.
You were not an introvert. When I first met you.
I grew into being an introvert.
Yeah, I think I was a bad influence on you.
Yeah.
You're welcome. People are overrated.
Vacation Eyes. Song about Danielle.
Yes, I know.
Oh, okay. You already
knew
that.
I did know.
I wasn't sure if you forgot.
No, I knew that.
This song is apparently about how Kevin and Danielle met.
I'm excited.
And reflecting upon them meeting on vacation.
I'm excited for it. And... I'm ready for, like, a nice, sweet love song.
Yeah.
I feel like this album has not had, like, a sweet love song yet.
Because this song is about Danielle, I'd like to hear some Kevin vocals.
We better hear Kevin vocals. We better hear Kevin vocals. Okay. I'm already liking it. It sounds sweet.
Oh,
or the saxophone solo.
They probably sampled something.
That sounds so familiar.
I could see
the layers out.
Yeah.
Okay, this is gonna sound so silly. That saxophone solo reminded me of when we were younger. Cammy's mom got us these bears that you would like press, I don't know, one of the paws and it would sing a song. And the saxophone sounded like the song that that little bear would sing. I'm not even kidding. I was like, I know that.
That's so funny.
It sounds, yeah. What was the song? I'll have to think of the song that it sang. And if I think of it, I'll let you know. But yeah, so that, the second I heard that, I was like.
It's so funny how that brought you back.
It did. It totally did, dude. Love the song. Love the lyrics. Love the sound. Love the saxophone solo. Definitely wish there had been more Kevin participation.
Also, I think that the saxophone sort of reminded me of like a Lines, Vines, and Trying Times vibe a little bit. The use of the saxophone reminded me of that era. And I think that that's kind of what they're doing. Like they're sort of reinventing a different kind of sound for them. Similar into 2009 when we had a little bit longer transition into Lines, Vines, and Trying Times. A lot of people didn't expect Lines, Vines, and Trying Times to like have the sound that it did. And I think that that's what this is compared to Happiness Begins. It's a more elevated sound. Yeah. But like you still have those like elements of Jonas Brothers in it.
Songs like this are for me what kind of brings it home, like how important it was for them to take that break to be able to grow as humans, as artists, and like, you know, because where they were going before they broke up wasn't, it wasn't this, and I don't think it was something that any of them were into at that point.
Yeah.
You know?
They didn't agree musically.
Right.
From what they told us in the
documentary. From what they've told us and from what you can hear in the music.
Yeah, and what you could see. I mean, me and Teresa have had this discussion before about how
so
when, in October of 2013, like, the two of us were not surprised in the least bit.
I was very accepting of it.
Right.
You know, because at that point, I mean, how old were they when they got like started singing? They were so young, like with like a It's About Time, like they're so young, and they spent like their whole lives doing that, and so they never really did get the chance to grow apart from each other, which is important, you know.
Yeah,
like it's important to grow, like family's important, don't get me wrong, but individuality is also important. And so songs like this make me appreciate that time that they got to spend apart, growing on their own, discovering themselves. Yeah. Because then they come back, and I really enjoyed this song.
I'm nervous for Summer in the Hamptons.
I am indifferent. I'm feeling the same way about the song as I'm feeling about the rest of the album.
I don't know how to feel about this. From what I've heard in the lyrics that I've read, the lyrics got leaked.
Naughty, naughty. I'm excited.
I like the wave sound effect at the beginning, though.
Yeah. This is already giving me, like, acid vibes.
Your
body takes me to some kind of place.
Yeah.
I'm kind of digging it.
Of course you are.
I liked the ending. They've been doing a lot of, like, layering, like, almost robotic sounding, I feel like, on this album.
Yeah. You know what this reminded me of?
It worked for the song.
It reminded me of, like, the Happy When I'm Sad of this album.
That sounds, yeah, I would agree with that. For sure. Which is funny, because Happy When I'm Sad, I liked it, but it wasn't my favorite.
It was definitely, like, simple to the point.
Very simple to the point.
I do like the sound effects. I like the wave at the beginning and everything. And
this is a beach song in your headphones.
Yeah. I don't know if we want to blast this out loud with
your
4-year-old in the car.
No. But I liked it.
I didn't hate it.
Well, that's good. You know what's the worst part about songs like this? It's because if you get it stuck in your head, the only line you're actually going to get stuck in your head is Zigzag Summer in the Hamptons. And then that's just going to be stuck in your head over and over and over again. I'll have to actually learn the rest of the song so that that part doesn't get stuck in my head constantly. But honestly, of all the, it's not going to be the song that I listen to the most on the album, but I do like it. All right, so the next song is Summer Baby. Yeah, like Van Morrison vibes. Not
anymore. This sounds like classic Jonas Brothers. That's my favorite part
like
so far.
It.
Falsetto.
I love
this.
That song makes me wish that Zach danced. I want someone to throw me to that song. I want to dance to that song.
You gotta convince him.
Yeah, right.
That might be my favorite so far.
It's up there. I would have to listen to my other top contenders.
Yeah, and compare.
Again, and compare.
I like how there's not too many effects on that song.
I did too. It just makes you want to just like, get the feeling
for you. Oh, that line with Nick though.
Then when he goes,
and then when he leads, like, still catching those feelings for you, and then he does that falsetto, he like, does, classic like, way Nick.
High. Yeah, was that the second or the third one that he went up?
I think it was the third one.
I think it was the third one. This song, I liked it all around. I liked the verses. I liked the chorus.
Yeah. It's fun.
It is fun.
It's just, it's
fun,
like,
but not pointless.
Right.
You know, which I like. Right. It'll be definitely my top five.
I don't know how we're going to feel about this next song, though.
Little Bird?
This is about them as fathers and their children.
I'm excited for it. Small hands, nothing on my fingers. Nights like these are happiness. So please just give me your fly into somebody else's arms, little bird. That's cute. I say it's gonna love you when I gotta leave you. Gotta believe it when the Lord takes me home. Oh, wow.
It's
just over 3 minutes.
Wow.
Yeah. So that's kind of cool. The second verse is about like when their daughters get like married, I guess. Yeah. And like when the Jonas Brothers like die. Which is fine, obviously.
I mean, it's
like,
gonna happen.
You know, they might get married and not everyone dies at some point.
But
they just feel like you have like literal like
babies.
Babies and like maybe like half a toddler. I was surprised that that's where they took it.
Yeah, I think that's second verse.
I thought they were gonna focus more on like the childhood aspect.
Right, right.
Which I think I might have appreciated more, but I still really liked them. If they put like little sounds of their kids. Like instead of cheering, just having it like maybe at the end have like what, like I love you daddy or something like that.
Oh yeah, like, that I would have
like coos and like gagas.
Yeah.
And stuff, that would have been cute.
Yeah, I think that would have added
to a little bit of sentimentality.
Yeah, I think so.
But it was cute. Alright, so the next and final song is Walls. It's featuring John Bellion. Would you like to read the fun fact?
John wrote the chorus to the Eminem song called The Monster and co-wrote and produced Trumpets by Jason Derulo.
I love both of those songs. But it's funny, earlier this year I was on a Trumpets kick. I hope I'm saying his last name right. Bellion. I hope that's how it's pronounced. Here we go. It's very churchy.
Yeah.
Like an organ. It's a very short verse.
I'm assuming this is where John Bellion comes in. More choir.
That's an actual choir.
Yeah. There's a lot going on here, guys.
Like, I liked the lyrics to the verses. I get to see lightning in her heart, never ending like waterfalls. I love that. Whenever your head lies to your heart, I'll love you all over and restart. I love that.
Yeah.
That's like, that's what love should, that's what love is, that's what love should be. That's great. I didn't like the chorus, which is the biggest part of the song and the longest part of the song. And the outro, oh, so I looked it up, Levantate and Amor.
Oh, yeah,
if it's
that?
From Spanish, it means rise up in love. Oh. Overall, I liked it.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna lie, I came in with kind of low expectations. I would say overall successful. And honestly, Wings probably will eventually grow on me. I don't know that Walls will.
Let us know what your top three songs are. Do you want to do top three or top five?
Dealer's choice if you guys have a top three or a top five.
And least favorite, because I think, I mean, some people
be
don't
honest,
have least favorite,
guys.
But
don't sit there and be like, all of the songs are fantastic because they're the Jonas Brothers. Like, no. People can have bad songs. I'm not going to do it in any particular order because I don't know the songs well enough yet. But I would say my top three are probably Miracle, Celebrate, and what was the other one I like?
You like Summer Baby.
Summer Baby?
Yeah.
I'm gonna say those three. Miracle, Celebrate, and Summer Baby.
I think I'm gonna go with the same songs as you because those were the ones that stuck in my head.
They come out swinging, dude. They came out swinging on those songs.
Summer Baby might be like my ultimate favorite from this whole track list. I do like Waffle House too, so that might...
I do like Waffle House, but I'm not... Like, again, I have to re-listen to the whole album. But I don't know that it's gonna surpass those three. But I have to listen to it again. But for now, I'm going with Miracle, Celebrate, Summer Baby.
Well, I think I'm gonna include Waffle House. I think I'm gonna do Celebrate, Waffle House, and Summer Baby.
Okay. Alright, well there you have it, guys. Like, comment, let us know what you thought of the album. If you're going to the tour, have so much fun. Maybe we'll see you there.